A very good morning all. As you know, we are talking about telecom traffic engineering, and in the previous lectures we have covered many fundamental or basic things related to the telecom traffic, such as the traffic pattern, the parameters related to the telecom traffic engineering, which is helpful to design any telecom traffic. Okay, then today we will see some important parameters and some numerical based on those parameters. So what is that one? First of all, this is very important things related to the telecom traffic. So I want that you should know what is our LUNS. It is the international unit of traffic after the name of A.K. Erlang, who laid the foundation to traffic theory. Okay, so this is very important point about the telecom traffic. So this is the international unit after the name A.K. Erlang. What is Erlang? In fact, a server is said to have one Erlang of traffic if it is occupied for the entire period of the observation. So Erlang, though it is unit, but how we define that unit? A server is said to have one Erlang of traffic if it is occupied for the entire period of observation. Okay, so if the server is busy for the entire period of observation, the observation period may be whatever. It may be 30 minutes, it may be 45 minutes, it may be 1 hour or more. So if for that period, that is the observation period, is occupying a server, then this is called one Erlang. One Erlang represent one circuit occupied for 1 hour. Generally, one Erlang represent one circuit occupied for 1 hour. So this is a standard one, observation period. The maximum capacity of a single server, that is our channel, is one Erlang. In that case, the maximum capacity of a single server is one Erlang. Server is always busy for 1 hour. Then calling rate is important parameters. Average number of requests for connection that are made per unit time. So what is the now average number of requests for connection or for call that are made per unit time? So in particular time, how many number of requests entered? If n is the average number of calls to and from a terminal during a period t second, then calling rate is defined as, so if n is the average number of calls which are made or put as a request, then calling rate, which is denoted by lambda, can be given as n upon t. Okay, the calling rate lambda is also referred as average arrival rate. So this is also called average arrival rate. Average occupancy is the ratio of average arrival rate, which we have seen in the previous slides, to the average service rate. Okay, that is the holding time. If the average number of calls to and from a terminal during a t second is n and the average holding time is h, the average occupancy of the terminal is given by the formula A is equal to n h upon t, where n is the average number of calls per unit time, h is the holding time, that is for how many time the call is hold, and t is the time period. So that n by t can be given by this one, that is n by t is given by this lambda. Here we have seen lambda n by t. So substituting this n here, n h n by t by lambda, h is it, and the reciprocal of holding time is known as the mu. Mu is called he is called the average occupancy. Okay, that is average service rate. Yeah, this one average service rate. Okay, so by substituting mu is equal to 1h, it is measured in Erlang. So this traffic intensity is measured into Erlang. Average occupancy is also referred as a traffic flow, traffic intensity, or traffic. So this average occupancy can be named as traffic flow. Please don't get confused, traffic intensity or carry traffic. There are more than one name, okay, or many names of traffic intensity. So when we'll do the experiment, then we'll see which terms we will find out there. Grade of service, again very important terms. GO is defined as the ratio of the lost traffic to offered traffic and its measure in percentage. So grade of service actually tells about the capacity of any exchange or telecom traffic, and this is given as the ratio of lost traffic to offered traffic. That is this one. Grade of service is equal to A minus A naught upon A, where A naught carry traffic, okay, जिसे आप क्या कह सकते हैं, traffic intensity, as we have seen previously, इसे हम traffic intensity भी कह सकते हैं. It has three names, okay. Then A offer traffic and A minus A naught lost traffic. Okay, तो offer traffic, carry traffic, offer traffic से if we minus carry traffic, then we have the lost traffic. And this lost traffic is very important factor to design it. And very important point is it is measured in percentage. So what is the significance of grade of service? Let me explain here. The smaller the value of GOS, the better is the service. So it should be small as possible. That is, this is the lost traffic, so it must be minimum as possible. The recommended GOS in India is 0.02%. Please remember this thing. 0.02%, that is 2 call out of 100 may lost. Okay. GO is applied to a terminal-to-terminal connection. So GO is not the story of any exchange. Actually, exchange is divided into many sections. So GOS depend on that one. Usually a switching center is broken down to following components. So GOS depend to the components of the exchange, which is divided into an internal call, subscriber is making to subscriber making call to switching office. So here GOS may be considered. Then an outgoing call to the trunk network, so switching office to trunk. So you are any calling subscriber is making a call to the other city, that is not in the same city. So it may be other things. Maybe you can get connected in locally easily, but when you are making a study call, then it may not be connected easily. The trunk network, that is ISD calls. A terminating call, that is switching office to subscribe. Okay, after the. So these are the levels or components of providing the GOS by the exchange. So when GOS provided, then of course it has to be done in all sections. GOS actually seen by the satisfaction of customer or subscriber. Okay. Example. Let's see some example related to these parameters. If a group of 20 trunk carries 10 Erlangs and the average call duration is 3 minutes, calculate average number of calls in progress, that is N, total number of calls originating per hour. Okay, so this is the questions, and we have to find out the answer of these questions. तो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल नोइंग अबाउट द आंसर लेट्स हैव व्हाट वी हैव इन हैंड व्हाट इज गिवन सो गिवन नंबर ऑफ ट्रंक्स 20 ट्रैफिक इंटेंसिटी ए 10 लंग्स होल्डिंग टाइम दैट इज दिस वन 3 मिनट्स and the average call duration that is for 3 minutes call is hold and observation period kitna ho aapka ye hoga aapka as per hour ke liye 60 minutes so these are the given things now let's have the solution so first of all traffic intensity per trunk okay traffic intensity per trunk How much traffic intensity a trunk will provide? Traffic intensity, total traffic, number of trunks. So total traffic intensity is 10. This is 10. Traffic intensity 10. Then number of total trunks. So after just dividing 10 by 20, we will get traffic intensity of each trunk. That is 0.5 hour long per trunk. ओके सो आपकी ट्रैफिक इंटेंसिटी पर ट्रंक कितनी है 0.5 आर लॉन्ग पर ट्रंक ओके एवरेज नंबर ऑफ कॉल्स पर ट्रंक फॉर वन आर लॉन्ग फॉर 60 मिनट्स ओके दैट इज ये देखिए आप ए ग्रुप ऑफ 20 ट्रंक कैरीज 10 आर लॉन्ग्स ओके सो व्हेन 10 आर लॉन्ग्स दैट इट मीन्स दिस इज फॉर वन ड्यूरेशन 1 hour, sorry. So then, average number of calls per trunk for 1 hour long for 60 minutes 20, as we have seen. So 4.5 hour long, average number of call in progress should be half, just half of it. Okay. So we can give the answer directly, but we need to find out this trunk hour long. Traffic per trunk. Okay. So this is the answer. Example second. Consider a group of 1200 subscriber which generates 600 calls during the busy hour. The average holding time is 0.22 minutes. What is the offered traffic in a long CCS and CM? So it's a little bit differ. We have to find out offered traffic. In a long CCS and CM okay so let's see what we have in hand n is equal to average traffic given holding time 2.2 minutes and duration is 60 minutes because this is the standard time to observe the server okay so whatever traffic we will find out it will be in a long and for 1 hour so let's find out Traffic intensity in Erlang, we know the formula NH upon T, where N is 600, H is 2.2, and duration is 60 minutes. So after calculation, we have the traffic intensity A is equal to 22 Erlang. Okay, so this is the 22 total traffic. Okay. But this is not the required answer. Though we have find out how much traffic intensity is there, but the answer should be in Erlang, then CCS, and then CM. All are the units of traffic intensity. Though not standard, but somewhere they have a relation. As we know. That 1 hour long is equal to 36 CCS. Already we have explained this, and then 1 hour long is equal to 3600 CS, and 1 hour long is equal to 60 CM. So you have to remember. Okay, this relation should be remembered by you. Now 1 hour long is equal to 1 hour that is total traffic intensity is 22 hour longs. So if we want to change into CCA, then what we will do? 1 hour long is equal to 1 अर्लांग इज इक्वल टू 36 ECS. तो 22 मल्टीप्लाई 36, दैट इज रिक्वायर्ड 792. सो दिस इज अदर आंसर. दिस इज वन आंसर, दिस इज वन आंसर, दिस इज सेकेंड आंसर. देन इट इज आस्किंग अबाउट द सी एम ऑल्सो. सो 22 मल्टीप्लाई 60, बिकॉज 1 अर्लांग इज इक्वल टू 60 cm. दिस इज द रिलेशन बिटवीन वेरियस यूनिट्स. एंड आफ्टर कैलकुलेशन वी आर हैविंग 1320 cm. सो गाइज, इट वॉज ऑल अबाउट द सिंपल पैरामीटर्स एंड सम न्यूमेरिकल बेस्ड ऑन दोज पैरामीटर्स. आई होप यू अंडरस्टैंड इट वेरी वेल. In the next lecture, we will discuss something other, some other things. Till then, have a great time. Take care.